a factory-produced solar arch that is still custom-built for our boat. This is how we did it.
So this will help us find the angles that are required for the arch to be in position.
This is not a good place to put an arch. We actually have to remove the cover, put the boat in the water. That means we need to do some paint jobs and a lot of other things. It's going to be a few hectic weeks now.
We don't have any solar panels on board the boat, meaning that when we stay out at anchor, we need to run the engine or seek up a marina pretty much every other day. So we really want to get solar on top of the boat. We also want this for the dinghy to be able to hoist it up into davit instead of just putting it on deck all the time. And so one of the big projects for this year is to get a solar arch with dinghy davits. And we found a company now that does this arch in a more modern way. Instead of making it from scratch by hand, by a blacksmith all the way up. So we found a company that can actually make a factory produced solar arch that is still custom built for our boat. And this is how we did it. This package will help us calculate the dimensions and the positioning of the entire arch by ourselves. So let's see what we got here. So we have some instructions on what to do, and we have received the measurement kit. So we have a inclinometer, we have some templates for the arch, and also some of the regular measurement tools to be able to place everything on deck as expected. But the first thing we need to do is to remove the cover. It's a beautiful morning here in Gothenburg. We just got the numbers back from Baltic Solar Arches. They've done the calculations and I know all the measurements of the arch. So I'm just gonna head up onto Eden and verify the positions and verify that everything is working with the bimini arch that we already have. So this is just the final conclusion of the numbers before we go into production. As I already have marked out the positions of the feet for the arch, it's quite easy now for me to just place a boat hook onto the position and use the angles, the inclinometer, to find the angles of the arch where it's supposed to go, so that I can see that it pauses on the outside of the bimini arch here. Let's see. Yeah, it's really important to get these calculations correct, otherwise the solar arch will actually bump into the bimini arch, and we have to do something about that. So now I'm done with the control measurements. I saw that there were some intersections between the solar arch and the bimini, which made me do some adjustments, and now everything is going to fit perfectly with the bimini, with the solar arch, and with backstays and the solar panels. So now we're gonna ship these numbers off to Mikkel at the Baltic Solar Arches, and they can start the production. And in a few weeks, we're probably going to have an arch to put, well, this is not a good place to put an arch. We actually have to remove the cover, put the boat in the water. That means we need to do some paint jobs and a lot of other things.
it's going to be a few hectic weeks now. So we were supposed to do a blasting of the hull, getting rid of all this, but it turns out that the marina, for this season, they don't allow blasting of the hulls anymore, so it's not possible. Instead, I have to do some kind of bare minimum scraping, put on the same anti-fouling as last season, or 2 years ago actually, that's why it's looking like this. Just a bare minimum job so that we can get the boat into the water, because we're splashing in like 2 weeks, and well, there's not a lot of time to do this. So, time to put on the sperm suit and get going. All dressed up, looking fabulous. I don't like it. It's nice, it's nice. Let's do this. So my plan is to use the Pro Scraper. I've been told by pretty much everyone that this is a scraper that is the best out there, and I can hook it up to the vacuum as well. So it's time to see what this thing is made of and if I'm gonna spend my last like coming 2 weeks here, or if it's just gonna take a couple of hours. Let's see. So grinding it's definitely faster, but also a lot heavier carrying this machine around above head height all the time. So I think I'll go with the scraper, and it's faster, but it doesn't get rid of the barnacles and the paint nearly as good as the scraper, although the surface of the scraper is not as even. So I'm gonna do the scraping of the entire hull. Let's see if I can do it in, what's people say, 2 hours. So, Emily, how long did that take? Half an hour? Not even an hour, perhaps 40 minutes. To scrape the entire side. Of course, it's not perfect in any way, but it's still, this Pro Scraper, it's just great. So, 6 hours later, everything's done. The whole hull has been scraped, and I've grinded away on the keel and all the other important parts. So, it really did go quite smooth. It's not the best of jobs, I can imagine. It's still looking like crap, but at least all the barnacles are gone, and I'm ready to put some paint on this thing to get it into the water. So, 2 more weeks until we splash it into the water. It is 5 a.m. and I'm taking a trip with the car over to Denmark to pick up the arch. We'll be right back.
we're in Denmark at the Grenå, and I'm heading down to the car to do the remaining part of the drive.
I made it all the way. I'm here in, I can't really pronounce the location I'm at, somewhere in Denmark, and the arch is supposed to be right outside here. So let's go take a look at what it looks like.
So this is my package. It's an arch and some solar panels, and basically this is supposed to fit in there, and I'm gonna take it back home with me to mount on the boat tomorrow. We're all packed up now. The arch is in the trailer, along with three solar panels and the dinghy hoist kit and everything. Let's pack up this stuff and head back to the ferry. I got a few hours before I need to be on the ferry on the way back, and I need to charge on the way as well, so it's a bit tight. Let's get going.
Cutting it close.
I just landed at the harbor in Frederikshavn, Denmark. I was about 4 minutes late. I still managed to get in and I'm now waiting to board the ship. I had a rough drive, way too slow, and my battery is almost drained. I mean, I have 4 kilometers left in the battery here. Luckily there's a horse ride in front of me, so I might get able to go home on that or something, because my battery won't. I'm happy if I can get on and off the ship with this battery now. Headwinds, even with a car, that sucks. I'm here. I probably will make it onto the boat as well, and then I'll be stranded in Gothenburg somewhere, and that's great. No worries. Sun is still shining. I'm gonna go out to sea again for the second time today. Brilliant. Soon home. Alright, so we got the arch at the boat, and we don't know really how to assemble this. We hope there are some instructions in this box here, but we got some pieces of metal here at the boat. So let's see what we got inside from Baltic. Dear customer, thank you, from Mikkels. I'll have to look up on the video, because I know there's a video online, but yeah, looks quite neat here. All the different assembly nuts, panel mounting kits, rods for assembling the arch, base plates, nice, yeah, and a nice rag to wipe everything off. Yeah, looks good. All right, we'll have to look up the videos then. We're gonna put it on the dock again to assemble it into all the pieces. This is a completely factory manufactured arch. So it's only based on the measurements we did a few weeks back, and then it's produced in a factory completely according to our specifications. So hopefully it'll be just working perfectly. We'll see. So this whole arch is in its full piece polished by putting it into acid bath, meaning that it's like polished everywhere, even underneath. And inside, it'll be polished to perfection. And it's all machine welded. Looking at these welds, it's just magnificent. these backing plates. They will be used on the inside of the hull. But I'm using this center hull as a guide to where the cables will come through. Because up here in the arch bolts, I have a cable inlet for all the solar panels. So the cables will go here through the holes. So here we're gonna drill three holes for fastening with M8 bolts. We're gonna have a backing plate on the inside, and then the cables will go through that hole. And there we have it. The whole arch is in place. Everything went perfectly smooth as usual. We forgot a bolt on a nut here and there, so I had to redo some parts. But all in all, everything worked out just as expected with the mounting holes and the positioning. So now it's time to unwrap the package and see what it looks like without all the bubble wrap. It's like Christmas Eve unwrapping a gift. A few more laps to go. It's taken us roughly 4 hours to assemble and mount the whole solar arch on the boat. So it really went quite smooth. Now we got the solar panels that we want to put on there as well. And we got three panels that we're going to go up there to give us 600 watts of solar power. And this arch was designed to use these panels, so they fit really well onto it. It's all like a package product from Baltic Solar Arches. And I must say I'm super impressed by the build quality and the measurements. They're so accurate to what we ordered. Like everything fits spot on. There's no room for wiggle or anything. It's just, yeah, it's really well manufactured, this arch. As I go up on the boat, I made a little mistake with my ladder down there. I have no idea how to get down from the boat. Shouldn't be too tricky unless I drop the hook as well. Yeah, check this out. So it's on the hook. Oh, no. Don't get out there. Yeah, like a pro. Coming to the rescue. No worries. I better consider this next time I'm going up here alone. That's, I could get stranded on the boat. -1 here. Lovely. Oh no. It's moving.